Thank you for plugging into this Family Life News podcast, streaming issues-driven, family-focused news. Welcome back to another edition of Capital Connection. Fridays, during the Noon Report, we give you direct connection to what's happening in Albany and Harrisburg with the experts on the issues at the state capitals. They are Dan Bartkowiak at the Pennsylvania Family Institute and Jason McGuire at New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms. Jason, I'll begin with you when I ask what's happening when it comes to the state budget. I imagine you would say not much. It's late for a second year in a row. That emergency stopgap will expire Monday. There's things like bail reform and public housing and even the minimum wage that still need to be ironed out. Who do you think, Jason, is going to blink first here, the legislature or the governor?
Well, I think, you know, we're at the stalemate at the State House is kind of the story of the week, and we don't yet have a budget. And I think the governor has indicated she's already blinking. There was action regarding whether or not she was going to slow down some of those climate change things regarding natural gas use in our state and allowing natural gas installations and new builds. Well, she's already said that's coming out of budget negotiations. She is blinking. Yeah. And so this is the situation we're having in the Empire State.
Maybe pumping the brakes a little bit on that mad dash to renewable energy. We'll see. I know a lot of folks have a lot of concerns about this effort to go fossil fuel free in New York. Along those lines, Dan, there was a proposal this week in Pennsylvania by Representative Chris Rabb, who leans way to the left. He wants to make your state one of the country's leading natural gas producers, completely fossil fuel free by 2050. Even though this is dead on arrival in the Senate, how worried are you about this rush to renewables in Pennsylvania?
Well, I think if you ask anyone what the biggest economic concern is for our state, it's going to relate to the high cost of living. Rates of inflation is the most universal tax of all. You know, poor, rich, everyone in between are impacted. So Pennsylvania lawmakers, you know, should be focused on ways to, frankly, get out of the way and help our economy grow, not create more economic problems. So this bill to ban all fossil fuels, which, by the way, the prime sponsor announced it by claiming the science is clear on climate control, links to a liberal activist group for his proof. But while the bill may not ultimately pass this session, it should alarm everyone that your state rep may support a ban on one of Pennsylvania's gold mine of exports. You know, we're the second largest producer of natural gas in the country. And so it's not hard to see how an outright ban on fossil fuels in Pennsylvania would not just be a ripple effect, but like a tidal wave effect of problems across the country.
Yeah. Well, Marijuana Incorporated is taking off in the Empire State. Jason, there was a lot of movement on that front. 2 years after the legalization effort, dozens more cannabis dispensaries were green-lighted this week. Now we are getting down to the brass tacks of this. What concerns you most about the proliferation of pot in New York?
Well, clearly it's the impact it's going to have on youth. We are seeing not just the legalization of recreational marijuana, but the commercialization of pot in our state. And that really is a product that is now being targeted towards children. Now, there have been some efforts to bring in some of the advertising regarding that, to bring in some of those things. But the bottom line is, you see statistically that more and more youth are now experimenting with pot because they believe it is harmless. The government has sanctioned it. What could be wrong with it? It's just the wrong message for the state to be sending to the youth of this and next generation.
Yeah, before we get to Dan, there was another big story this week in New York, Jason. I'd also like you to chime in on this. The Attorney General James tearing apart this law in West Virginia, which basically makes it so biological boys can't compete in girls' sports. Why is the AG so fixated on this issue?
Well, identity politics certainly drives the debate today. And you see that in the far left, the progressive movement, drag queens seem to be the new heroes of the day. A couple of weeks ago, the Attorney General actually hosted a drag queen story hour in Greenwich Village. Now she is looking to impact even what is happening in transgender issues in West Virginia. This is clearly a move that the progressive Letitia James is making that satisfies her very left base.
Yeah, I see a lot of other states now, Kansas, Missouri, even Florida now are pushing to save women's sports from this. Dan, House Democrats this week unveiled a measure that would ban so-called gay conversion therapy. That's what they're calling it. I like what Jason calls it. He calls it the counselor coercion bill. The argument on the other side of this is anti-gay bias that masquerades as science. What say you to this issue, and why is this debate coming up now in Pennsylvania?
Well, Jason's right of a counselor coercion bill, and Jason pointed out a few things of really targeting our children, and that's really what we're seeing. So many parts of this dangerous agenda that targets kids. Here in Pennsylvania, you know, House Democrats want to fund puberty-blocking drugs being given to eight-year-olds, gender surgeries on minors. I mean, many of these same state legislators deny the reality of the problem faced by detransitioners, you know, those who regret the irreversible harm done often on minors at gender clinics. Yet the sponsors of this bill, you know, the ban of so-called conversion therapy, call items related to detransitioners fake issues. There's nothing fake about the harm done to people like Chloe Cole, who had puberty blockers and testosterone at age 13, double mastectomy at age 15. You know, she's 18 now, regrets what happened to her, literally lost healthy organs as a minor because adults failed her. And now she lives the rest of her life with this permanent harm. I mean, Pennsylvania's constitution, you want to point at this, the state's all free governments are instituted for the safety of its people. We're not keeping girls safe by prescribing them testosterone at age 8. So, you know, specifically to this bad bill on the counselor conversion therapy, it's House Bill 575. Government shouldn't be restricting a person's therapy goals. Mental health professionals, pastors, counselors, licensed therapists should have the freedom to counsel those with unwanted same-sex attraction.
I don't know if you heard Jason or not, but Donald Trump was indicted, arraigned, and arrested this week. Front page news. Some are saying this is a bump for Trump in his desire to be the Republican presidential nominee in 2024. Do you think that this unprecedented courtroom proceeding has sealed the deal for Trump next year, or is this just a case of short-term gain, long-term pain for the former president?
Yeah, you know, I think it remains to be seen. I mean, certainly I think that, you know, the district attorney, Alvin Bragg, has just abused his office in this particular matter. It is wrong what the DA has done. And I'm not surprised that there is that bump that you initially see. I think that is an indication that many Americans have recognized that this is the wrong application of justice in this particular matter. This is not how it should be pursued. I think those poll numbers will tend to cool, though, as time goes on. It's not uncommon to see the bump with the former president's name in the news. You saw no other candidates mentioned. Really, he just took all the oxygen out of the room this week, and we'll see what happens long term with this presidential campaign.
Yeah, Dan, I thought it was interesting. Of those declared, and there will be more, I know there's a guy in Florida that spoke in your state recently who is going to bump up on the radar screen soon. But of all those who have declared, only Asa Hutchinson has said, hey, maybe Trump, you should not run. It seems like everybody else is in Trump's corner here. When it comes to Ron DeSantis, what's the sense that you're getting about how Pennsylvania Republicans feel about him campaigning for the highest office in the land?
Yeah, well, you can't deny that Governor DeSantis has an impressive resume and a long list of accomplishments. Certainly in Pennsylvania, one glaring difference is comparing PA and Florida with government shutdowns from COVID. You know, very different approaches. He has family roots in Pennsylvania. So when he had his speech at the Pennsylvania Leadership Conference recently, if you're a baseball fan, he started out talking about when he was at the Little League World Series as a participant, taught him how to swing for the fences in life. But perhaps the loudest cheer at that event was when he talked about the response to the problem I brought up earlier, the puberty blockers and irreversible gender surgeries on minors.
Yeah.
You know, he said, that's not medical science. It's ideology run amok. And he's absolutely right. Yeah. And now any physician who does that harm to minors in the state of Florida loses their medical license. So his speech is available online. You know, I certainly recommend watching Governor DeSantis' full address to those at the recent Pennsylvania Leadership Conference.
All right. We'll see when he makes that announcement. It's going to be an interesting 2024 with the trial, with the primary season coinciding. I guess that's why politics is such a fascinating thing to study in this country. But that is all the time we have this week. If folks have questions about any of the topics brought up today, Jason, you have a wonderful website. Where can they find you?
AlbanyUpdate.com.
Stay informed on all the issues in Pennsylvania as well. Dan, where can folks find you?
PAFamily.org.